Hello, I am Maureen Mesrimas, a Squantum resident and chairperson of the Department of Public Works Stormwater Advisory Committee. Formed in 2015, the committee provides an opportunity for local residents to directly shape city stormwater policy. As residents, we often have detailed knowledge of stormwater issues in our neighborhoods, and this information can assist the DPW in prioritizing their efforts. One of the many issues that the Stormwater Advisory Committee works on with the DPW is to promote clean waterways through the department's illicit discharge detection and elimination program. This program is a cost-effective and efficient program that identifies defects in our sewer system, which may present problems for our waterways. Now let's go to Zach, one of our engineers in the field, to see one of our illicit detection crews in the investigation process.
Good afternoon, we're in Elmwood Park, and we're here with the field crews, City of Quincy field crews, that are continuing to assess the city's sanitary sewer system. What makes assessment particularly difficult is all of the important infrastructure is underground. We have important water lines going into apartment buildings, we have the wastewater that comes out of buildings, and we have a drainage system here also that parallels, sometimes crosses, both of those pipes. What we're doing today is really looking for particular problems in the drainage system that would be indicative of what we might find in defects in the sewer. Similar to most of New England, the city of Quincy's infrastructure is well aged. The average age of sewer pipe in Quincy is about 94 years, which is not unlike most communities in New England. But compared to the rest of the country, where the average age of sewer is around 45 years. So in order to assess the condition of pipes that are largely buried, what we need to do is have rapid assessment techniques. This technique that this crew is demonstrating here is looking in the drainage system for indications of sewage. All the drainage here flows to the Neponset River watershed, an important water body for the city of Quincy. You might be able to see there at the bottom of the manhole, there is a little bit of flowing water today. We have been out here during dry conditions, and so there may be some base flow, but what we are looking for is flowing water in these drain systems. If there's flowing water, we then assess these for ammonia and soaps as indicators of potential sewage. Most people don't recognize this, but the drainage systems in your neighborhoods all end up in the waters of the U.S. So anything that ends up in the drain ends up there. The importance of this work in order to find proactively and rehabilitate the sewer system, we need to assess the sanitary sewer infrastructure for defects. If there are defects, those can end up revealing themselves in the drain system. We want to get that pollution, any sewage, out of the drain system quickly and effectively. This helps the city to identify and prioritize key areas to deliver rehabilitation efforts. Grab a sample from the drainage system manhole, and again we're looking for sanitary sewage indicators. That sample is then assessed for ammonia, surfactants, and chlorine, all things that we wouldn't typically find in stormwater but that we may find in sewage. The crews can conduct a rapid field test kit right here in the field, get results, and then move on to the next site. The goal here is isolation of a pipe segment so that we can find our sanitary sewer defects for rehabilitation.
Thank you. I'm Chris Hirsch with the Neponset River Watershed Association, member of the Quincy Stormwater Management Committee. Quincy is a city rich with a lot of aquatic resources, like the marsh we're standing in right now, the Neponset River behind me, and the many great beaches. Quincy water is a way of life, and the IDDE program helps to keep contaminations out of that water, because the people that swim, fish, and boat in the waters here in Quincy deserve to do so without having to worry that they're going to get sick from the water. And that fish and wildlife that call this place home also deserve clean water. And so on behalf of the association, I'd like to thank the Quincy DPW for all of their dedicated work trying to get contaminations out of the stormwater system and out of our waters.
Don't forget, clean water is everybody's business.